your iMessage is under attack from spam texts, robo-texts, political texts, and advertisements for products from companies you have no interest in, then this video was made just for you. I'm Dylan Stewart, the Mac Whisperer, and in today's video, I'm going to teach you how to use the new iOS 26 message filtering feature to streamline and clean up your text message conversations so they're less distracting, less frustrating, and you can have better communications with the people you actually care about. Make sure to stick around for my MacWhisperer Power tip. And if you'd like to follow along with today's lesson, scan this QR code to download your free smart guide, which will walk you through everything we're going to talk about today. iMessage is my favorite communication tool, mostly because email got overrun with junk mail and spam messages years ago. But in the last couple of years, text messages are also under attack from spam texts, robo-texts, and all sorts of advertisements as more and more companies infiltrate my pristine iMessage. But thankfully, with iOS 26, Apple's added a fantastic new message filtering feature that makes it easy to screen out all of those calls and take back your iMessage. The first thing we're going to do is hop into iMessage itself right here. Once you get into iMessage, you're going to notice in the upper right-hand corner this new filter icon. The filter icon gives you a ton of options, and we're going to be in it a lot today. Let's click on it. You'll see a number of options, but the one I want to start with is this one at the bottom that says Manage Filtering. When you click it, it'll open up the Settings app to the iMessage section and point you right to the Unknown Senders section. This is a new feature since iOS 26. Before we start clicking buttons, let me explain what unknown senders are. Unknown senders are anyone who's not in your address book or texting you from a blocked number. We get all sorts of texts from our friends and from our family on a regular basis, but we also get texts from companies that aren't in our address book. Some of these are companies that we bought things from or legitimately given our phone number to. But in a lot of cases, your phone number might have been sold on the open market to God knows who. And all of those people are trying to communicate with you directly through text messages. This can result in things like toll roads texts that make you think you owe a bill, or a social security text that makes you think you owe money, or an IRS text. All of these random people are pretending to be real companies that we work with. But now with this new message filtering feature and the unknown senders capability, we can screen out a lot of those conversations from people that aren't in our address book and that we don't want to talk to. The first thing we're going to do is click where it says Screen Unknown Senders. This means that any messages from people who aren't in our address book will go to a separate section automatically. Within a few minutes, you should see a difference. Let's check out my iMessage and see how it looks. There were several other texts here from other companies. There was a couple of verification codes, some transaction codes, even a couple of spam messages that aren't here anymore. Where'd they go? Well, if we click on the filter button in the upper right-hand corner, you'll see a new section called Unknown Senders. And it's gathered any of those messages here in one place so that they don't interrupt my basic iMessage inbox. Clicking on Unknown Senders shows me all of these messages. And as you look through these messages, you can respond to them or mark them as known as need be. Here I've got a verification code from Amazon. I know Amazon, so I can click the Mark as Known button. And what that does is it adds that Amazon text number to a list of known text senders. So I don't have to put Amazon in my address book for these text messages to not get caught by the unknown senders filter, which is really helpful. If we come into any of these messages, like this one up at the top that says maybe spam, you can delete it from here or mark it as known. When you mark it as known, you'll get an opportunity to add it to your address book if it's a person you regularly talk with. But if it's a company that you work with that's legitimate, clicking mark as known eliminates it from the unknown senders filter. This is a step in the right direction, but there's more to do. Come back to that filter button and click on it again. Come back down to the Manage Filtering section to go back to Settings to see what else we can do. Down below here, we have an option for allowing notifications. Some of these unknown senders are legitimate. Let me show you what I mean. Here we've got a text code that came from Dropbox. I use Dropbox. That is definitely a legitimate text. And down here, I've got one from my health plan premium. This is a purchase that's legitimate. I need to be able to see this. And down below there, I've got an order that was ready at a restaurant that I went to the other day. That's also legitimate, and this FedEx one is also legitimate. So I don't want to eliminate the legitimate text messages. I need to be alerted when they come in. Coming back to the filter and back to manage filtering, that's where we can come into this allow notifications section. And there's four options here. Time-sensitive alerts, which are generally verification codes or urgent requests. Not all time-sensitive texts are legitimate, but a majority of them are, so I'm going to leave that notification on. Below that, we've got one called personal. This is texts from unknown senders that are verified to not be from a business or an organization. On the surface, this seems like it might be a good thing to turn on, and some people have recommended turning it on, but I find that many of these spam providers are not showing up as businesses or organizations, they're showing up as individuals, which means that if I turn that on, a lot of spam texts and pretend texts from the toll roads or Social Security might hit me, and I don't want to be bothered by that. So I'm going to leave that one off. Down below that, we've got one for transactions. This is when you purchase something or order something. So FedEx deliveries count as transactions, as well as that restaurant that I went to that wanted to tell me that my order was ready. So I'm going to leave that turned on. And down below that, we've got a notification for promotions. This would be if I wanted to be alerted every time a company had an advertisement or a marketing text that they sent me. There's no reason to turn that on. Those are mostly junk. So I recommend setting it up with the time sensitive turned on and the transactions turned on and the personal and promotions turned off, but you may need to play around with it to make sure it's perfect for you. Down below the allow notifications section, we've got something called a text message filter. Before we take a look at that, let's come back to messages to see how it looks. As we come into my message chain, we see all of the personal messages that I've got. Clicking on the filter button in the upper right-hand corner shows me all of our tools. You'll notice we've got the unknown senders right here, and clicking on it, here are these unknown senders like we saw them before, but they're all mixed up and connected. Down here, we see one that's maybe spam, but it's not sure. Here we've got one from FedEx, and here we've got one from the TikTok marketing team. Total junk, right? So let's come back to our filter and back to manage filtering, and let's click on the text message filter here. There's a built-in option to turn on this text message filter just by clicking right here. What that does is it separates the unknown senders into different categories. Let's see what that looks like. Coming back into our filters, you'll notice that we have new options. Up at the top, we've got something called transactions. And if we click on that, you'll see multiple different kinds of transactions. You can go to the All Transactions section, or you can come into the Transactions section and go to Finance. This will show you any purchases that you've made. Coming back into the transactions section, you can go into orders. This tells me orders from my pharmacy or from that restaurant or from FedEx or from Frontier. Coming back into the filter and back into transactions, we can also go to the reminders section. The reminders section is for texts that are reminding you about upcoming payments or maybe your parking meter is about to expire. Let's come back in here. We'll also notice that we have a separated promotions section. Clicking here shows you the promotional messages that you've got from text. There's not much here at the moment because I keep this pretty clean, but over time you'll see this grow, and this is a great place to clean things up. Remember that when you open up any of these texts, you can report them as spam if you want to, but you can also come into any message chain and type the word stop and click send in order to remove yourself from that company's text message list. Sending the word stop in a text is a universal unsubscribe code that will immediately remove you from that person's list. I strongly recommend replying with the word stop to any text message conversation that you no longer want to receive, even if you're going to mark it as spam or delete it, because by sending that word, it automatically unsubscribes you and takes your number off their list, which prevents them from selling your number to other people, which can keep you from getting additional texts down the road. If it's a legitimate company like T-Mobile, don't mark it as spam because that'll cause problems down the line. But if you don't need that message, you're welcome to delete it at any time by swiping from the right side to the left side and deleting it right here. You'll get another opportunity to report it as spam, but don't do that for legitimate companies or it'll cause problems down the road. Coming back to our filter, there's one more option here called spam. and the spam filter attempts to grab any known spam providers and put them all in this list. So messages from the toll roads or from overseas numbers like this +63 number from the TikTok hiring team will immediately end up in this filter. But there's a way to augment this filter by another level. And to do that, we're going to go back to settings. Click on the filter, back to manage filtering, and from here we're going to turn on the filter spam option. That's going to make sure that anything that is a known spam provider doesn't show up at all. There's no notifications, and it's immediately hidden and grabbed into its own filtered section. Now that we've got that turned on, when I come into spam, it's automatically going to keep track of all of these spam senders, and if I don't do anything, it will automatically delete them after 90 days. It's a good idea, especially at first, to take a quick glance through and make sure there is no legitimate messages in here. But as far as I'm concerned, anything that comes from a +63 number is automatically junk. +61 number is also overseas for me, so that doesn't matter. As I look through all of this, the only one that I'm curious about is this representative from YouTube. Let's take a look at that for a second. It's somebody offering me a job through YouTube. That can't be legitimate. I think this filter was right, and that's also spam. So it's grabbed all of these numbers. One of the important things to know about spam providers is it's very common for them to spoof your phone number. With this Charles Schwab message, it comes from a phone number that's very, very close to my real phone number, which makes people think that must be legitimate. Except if we come into it, we can see that it was sent to 18 people. It's clearly part of a spam text. And once again, the spam filter did its job grabbing everything properly. Once you've turned on these separate filters, you're going to need to pay attention to the filter icon in the upper right-hand corner. So let's talk about that for just a moment. You'll notice that the filter icon is blue, and up at the top it says spam. That is because the filter is engaged and we're connected to the spam section. If I click on the filter and go to unknown senders, you'll notice it's still blue, but up at the top it says unknown senders. It's letting you know which section of the filter is turned on. But you want to be careful not to leave the filter turned on perpetually, because that's going to prevent you from seeing your actual texts. So anytime you notice that the filter is blue and you want to see all of your messages, you should click on it and come up to the top where it says messages. You'll notice that now the filter icon is white instead of blue, letting us know that the filter is off and that we're seeing all of our messages in one place. You'll also notice that there's a number one there, which is a notification from one of the recent texts that I've received. When you first turn on these filtering tools, that number may be a lot higher than one. If you see a large number there, I strongly recommend clicking on the filter and paying attention to where the numbers show up. You should go through all of those texts and clear them out so that when new messages come in, they don't get lost in the shuffle of all of the old messages that were marked as unread. Marking something as read clears that number. So we can see here under transactions, it says I've got one that's new. Let's click on transactions. It says it's a part of the all transactions section, so let's click on that. And up at the top, we've got this message that's a response from our stop command that we sent to T-Mobile. And that's probably the message we were looking at. If the text that you have in any of these filters are still showing as unread, you can mark them as read, and you should, but the notification number won't show for messages that are older than a few days. It's easy to mark something as read by swiping from the left side to the right side to clear it. But you can also clear out these messages if you don't need them at all. Let's click the Edit button and click Select Messages. I can either click Select All in the upper right-hand corner here to clear everything at once, or I can select individual messages by clicking on the little dot to the left, or I can put my finger on the circle and scroll down to select multiple messages at the same time. Once you've got all of the ones ready, you can mark them as red in the lower left-hand corner like that, or you can delete all of them by clicking on the trash icon on the right, just like this. Again, you'll have an opportunity to report them as spam, but don't do that if they're legitimate, because that's going to cause an issue. I don't need any of these texts anymore, so I can click delete and I can clear all of them out at once. But the filter is still engaged. You can tell because it's blue. Let's click on it again and go back to where it says messages. Now you'll notice that there's no notification on my filter button because I've cleared out all of the unknown senders and spam messages that were showing up as new. Now I can go back to using my phone and texting my friends and family and communicating with everyone in my life without worrying about getting hit by those spam texts, those robo-texts, or those political texts. Yes, for legitimate companies, it's worth it to send the stop command. Again, it removes you from their list and it takes your number off their list so that they can't sell that number to someone else. If you're getting tons and tons of political texts or other kinds of texts, you may have to hit stop multiple times until you can get off all of the separate lists. But it's worth it, and over time it will slow down the messages you're getting, and it will prevent your number from being infiltrated by other companies who are going to use that number to advertise to you or send you texts with links that you absolutely should not click on. So that's a pretty amazing feature, this new message filtering. But there's one more thing I want to talk about. Before I drop my MacWhisperer Power tip, if you've already learned something or gotten great value from this video, give it a thumbs up. That goes a long way to helping other people find this video, and I appreciate it. If you've got a question, a comment, something you don't understand, or something you need more information about, drop it in the comments section. I absolutely love to hear from you guys. And if you haven't subscribed to my channel yet, now is a great time to do that because there's a ton of new videos coming up and I would hate for you to miss any of them. Hit that subscribe button and that notify bell so you're always alerted whenever I drop new content. And with that being said, let's get into the power tip. It's awesome that Apple added these new message filtering tools, but they're not just for avoiding spam. There's another feature built into the message filtering tools that's super, super helpful. And once again, we're going to find it by clicking on the filter button right here. When you come into here, you're going to notice that there is a section down at the bottom that says recently deleted. This means if you accidentally deleted a text or a text chain, you can easily recover it by coming into the recently deleted section and selecting any text message chain that was accidentally deleted, like this one here, and clicking where it says recover in the bottom left. That'll bring back any messages from that chain immediately. It'll hold on to deleted text chains for up to 30 days, and then they'll automatically be deleted for good. But if you deleted it accidentally, hop in here, take a look, grab anything you need, and pull it right back in. Simple and easy. But that's not the only power tip for the filter tool. Let's come back in. You'll also notice down at the bottom, two additional filter options, one of which is the filter by unread. If you're unsure of what messages you haven't seen or you're trying to get caught up, this is a great way to do that. By clicking filter by unread, it only shows you messages that are unread, which is a great way to catch up on messages that you either didn't see or forgot to respond to. Here I can see that I've responded to this message so I can mark it as read, but I forgot to talk to Peter here. Let me hop on into his text chain and let him know that I'll send him some options for an appointment later today. Now I can send that message off to him, and when I come back into the unread section down here, that message is gone, but there are other messages that I still need to respond to. This is a great way to catch up, and if there's things you don't need, all you have to do is swipe on them to mark them as read. I strongly recommend coming into this section and clearing off as much as possible. If you're someone who's got hundreds and hundreds of unread texts, between the message filtering and the unread filter, you should be able to clear almost all of them out. When you have a ton of unread texts, it's really hard to know when you have new texts coming in, and it's almost impossible to get caught up. So this is a great place to come to clear things out and make it simple. And the last power tip is again underneath the filter section, and it's something called drafts. Have you ever started a message and then gotten distracted? Yeah, of course you have. Back on the 19th of December, I sent this message to a friend of mine, but I didn't finish sending it. If I come back into this list here, you're gonna find that I was in the middle of the conversation with Frank here, and I obviously dropped it out. By having this draft filter, it means that you can come through any of the messages that you started to send and clear them out if you no longer want to send them. As I come into Lance here, I've already talked to him and had an appointment with him, so I can clear this message and remove it from this list. You can also press the edit button up here in order to select multiple messages, and then you can mark them as unread or delete them if you don't need them. And you can also do that under the unread section, allowing you to click edit, select messages, and read all to mark all of your unread texts as read at once. I don't want to do that because I keep track of a lot of messages based on what I have and haven't responded to, but if you've got hundreds or thousands of unread texts, this is the simplest and easiest way to get on the other side of that. So that's what we've got for today's video, all about how to use the new iOS 26 message filtering features and the other filtering features to streamline your iMessage conversation and make everything easier. If you haven't had a chance to do it, don't forget to hit this QR code to download your free smart guide. I hope you learned a ton in today's lesson, but remember, there's always more to learn. Check out this video over here for even more amazing Apple tips and tricks to make everything easier. I'm Dylan Stewart, the Mac Whisperer, and I'll see you in the comments.